Today on the Foreign Fork, we are traveling to France and we're gonna taste a bite of one of their most famous hors d'oeuvres, escargot. Are you ready to eat some snails? Hey everybody, welcome to the Foreign Fork. My name's Alexandria and this is the Foreign Fork Kitchen where we are cooking one meal from every country in the world. And today we are heading to one of my very, very favorite countries with some of the best cuisine in the world, France, and we're gonna be making one of their favorites, escargot. To get started, the first thing that you're gonna need is 1 tablespoon of butter. I have a medium pan heating up over medium heat, and I'm gonna melt 1 tablespoon of butter in the pan. Next to this, we are gonna add 1 shallot that I've minced very finely, and then we need to add the snails. So when I'm making this recipe, I use a can of snails. The snails are already cooked in the can. I'm gonna add 12 snails into this pan, and that's because I have an escargot pan that only holds 12 snails. If you have an escargot pan that can hold more than 12 snails, you can cook more than 12 at one time, but I don't wanna waste them, so I'm just gonna make just 12 for my pan. I'm just gonna stir the snails and the shallots and the butter together for about 2 minutes, just so that the snails can kinda sweat out any of the juice that they have in there, and then we'll move on to the next step. When you go to a restaurant and they're serving escargot in the shell, here's a secret, a lot of the times it's actually just canned snails that get stuffed into empty shells. This is the easiest way to make them. You don't have to take them out of the shells or anything like that. If you want to serve them in the shells, there are recipes for those. I'll put them in the link in the description of this video, but I think this is the easiest way to do it. So these have been cooking for 2 minutes, so I'm going to now layer them into my escargot pan. I got this pan off of Amazon. It delivered in 2 days. I'll put the link in the description of the video too, so that if you want to purchase an escargot pan, you can get one. Now what I'm gonna do is scoop 1 snail into each of the little compartments. You can add some shallots in there too. If you can get some shallots in your scoop, don't be afraid to put some shallots in the little crevice as well. We're gonna set those aside for a moment. We're done with our pan, so you can put that off to the side as well. And now we're gonna make the garlic butter. You can use this recipe for anything that you need garlic butter for too, but it's perfect for escargot. So into a blender or food processor or a little single serving blender, that's my favorite choice for this, you're gonna add 5 tablespoons of softened butter, 3 teaspoons of garlic. Yes, that's a lot, but it's wonderful. 1/4 cup of parsley and 1 tablespoon of white wine. Chardonnay is the recommended white wine to drink if you're eating escargot. So if you're gonna be enjoying a bottle of wine while you're enjoying your French appetizer, open up a bottle of Chardonnay and just put 1 tablespoon into the recipe too. We will put the lid on and then blend this up. Okay, so now it's time to assemble the escargot. So I have the snails in the escargot pan and we're gonna put the garlic butter on top. So you can put maybe about 1 teaspoon or so of butter on top of each of the snails. If you want to make more than 12 snails at a time, you can also use a mini muffin pan. That's what I did when I was having a dinner party and I needed to make more than 12 snails. We used a mini muffin pan and we could fit a lot more in there too. Lastly, we're gonna put a little sprinkle of breadcrumbs on top of the butter on each snail. I have about 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs here, so that should be more than enough. I have my oven preheated to 375 degrees and I'm gonna bake the escargot in the oven for about 10 to 15 minutes until they start to brown on top. Now that the escargot is baking, we're gonna make some buttered toast to eat the snails with. So I have a small little cookie sheet here, and I'm gonna put, I don't know, about 12 to 15 pieces of toast on this cookie sheet. This is a French baguette that I sliced into about 1/2-inch pieces or so. These ones I bought pre-sliced, they're a little bit thicker than what I would have wanted, but they'll still work. We're gonna melt our last 3 tablespoons of butter in a little microwave safe dish, and then we're gonna brush it on top of the bread pieces. Yes, there is a lot of butter in this recipe, but that is the beauty of French cooking. The modern day recipe for escargot was invented around 1814 when Napoleon's steward Talleyrand wanted to have lunch with Tsar Alexander I. By the time they got to the restaurant, there was nothing left for the chef to make except for snails. So in order to make them a little bit more appetizing, he added butter and parsley to the top of them. And the men loved the recipe so much that it became one of the most popular recipes around the world, but especially in France. The French people love snails so much that they eat about 16,000 tons of snails per year, especially around the holiday time. I have my oven on a high broil, and so I'm going to move the oven rack closest to the top of the coils in the oven and put the baking sheet right underneath the coils. I'm gonna keep a close eye on my bread because broiling causes things to burn very quickly. So I'm gonna keep an eye on them until these turn nice and toasty and then pull them out. So if you're wondering what escargot tastes like, I will tell you the same thing that I told my friends when I was convincing them to try it. Pretty much just a vessel to get garlic butter and breadcrumbs into your mouth. If you've been a little hesitant to try escargot, I'd really encourage you to try it because it surprises a lot of people and it's really delicious. Thank you so much for watching this video and for traveling to France with me. I hope you enjoyed our French appetizer and that you make it at home and it becomes a wonderful, easy to make, but delicious appetizer when you're hosting friends or even just want to have a fancy dinner. If you need the full written instructions, you can find them in the description below this video. Don't forget to check out all of the other recipes that we have on the Foreign Fork YouTube channel. There are awesome, awesome recipes from all over the world, including some awesome appetizers that you can make as well. Don't forget to put some culture in your kitchen this week, and I will see you next week. Bye.